case is a 66 years old male patient known to have diabetes and insulin but not hypertensive, complaining of a persistent epigastric pain radiating to the back for 4 months. CT and MRI abdomen show a well-defined multi-molecular predominant EUS secretion in the pancreatic tail and the adjacent body, measuring 5 by 3 by 4 centimeters. It showed a mixed signal intensity in T1 and T2. PET scan show a multi-reculated cystic lesion occupying pancreatic body and tail, showing multiple variable sized cysts with metabolically active enhancing irregular soft tissue thickening reaching up to 5.9 SUV max in corresponding images. The mass measures about 3 by 5.6 by 6 centimeters and is inseparable from the undersurface of the gastric greater curvature. EUS FNA was done and revealed multilocular complex cystic lesion 28 by 50 millimeter in the pancreatic body. It has a highly irregular thick wall 3 millimeter with multiple echogenic areas inside. Pathology show a benign retention cyst compatible with pancreatic pseudocyst, no epithelial cells or mucus identified, no ataxia or malignancy seen. Analysis of the cystic fluid. Amylase 80,002.1, CA 1990 above 700. The repeated EUS shows the pancreatic head, body, and tail are obviously enlarged with heterogeneous texture, showing a multiple necrotic area, the largest located in the pancreatic body, measuring 10 by 13 millimeters. There is a large multilocular complex cystic lesion in the pancreatic body measuring 50 by 100 millimeter. Previously it was measuring 28 by 50 millimeter. It has a slightly irregular wall, 5 millimeter thick with necrotic area and tuberous inside. EUS-FNA was done and revealed thick postulating secondary infected cystic pancreatic neoplasm and 12F pancreatic necrosis. Patient was referred for repeated EUS examination and possibility of cystogastrostomy.
السلام عليكم دكتور علي.
عليكم السلام حسين. في سؤال بس قبل ما نكمل.
ايوه.
اللي اتقاس جوه السيست سي اي ايه ولا سي 19-9؟
هما الاثنين اتعملوا، هو ده انا عياني انا فانا عارفه كويس قوي.
يس.
العيان ده مشكلته ان هو جايب بكومبلكس سيست والمشكله الازليه ذا اندلس ديبيت اوف بينج سيستك بانكرياتيك نيوبلاس اور انفلاماتور سودو سيست اور وورد اوف بانكرياتيك نيكروزس. Before commencing cystogastrostomy or any maneuver, we should differentiate and we should do FNA and analysis. FNA revealed no mucin stain, benign cells, no suspicious cells or dysplastic or malignant cells, but there were several pus cells, so it is infected fluid. And the tumor markers inside the cyst is as follows. Amylase thousands, about 7,000 I think, or 8,000, and CEA is 17 only, and CA 19-9 I think it is 400 or 500 as you so the analysis of the cyst fluid biochemistry is with benign lesion, and also cytopathology is with benign lesion. The only odd thing which maybe not malignant lesion, that the patient did PET scan, and PET scan revealed a high SUV max of the wall of the cyst and inside the cyst, so suggesting malignant rather than a benign tumor.
We have a question here, Dr. Kasr.
Yes.
Now the cyst is multi-reculated.
No, it is not so much, yeah, as you will see, one or two reculus, but I think the reculi is communicating with each other. It is not closed compartments, I think so. But you may face this problem. And a very nice question, an intelligent question, what you do if you have 3 or 4 closed compartments of the cyst. Someone advised multi-gate putting two stents in the biggest two compartments, and some prefer surgery. The Professor Hakan, we can give us his opinion.
Okay.
It will multi-related cyst and the closed cyst.
All the examination findings are pointing towards an infected pseudocyst or lot of pancreatic necrosis. But as you said from the floor, the presence of multi-localization is not very usual in lot of necrosis, but there are some adhesions. Presence of CEA level of 17, it is very low, is standing against an mucinous system. Furthermore, the patient had a history of pancreatitis, as I understand. So presence of history of an acute pancreatitis and the cyst with high amylase, low CEA, are all pointing towards volto pancreatic necrosis. And besides this, the pathology also revealed the same finding. So for this patient, now we are going to examine and we are going to see it together. It is probably a pseudocyst. So if we do not have any further problem with the diagnosis, we are going to go ahead with cystogastrostomy. But if we have any suspicion, of course, we would not do it, but I am going to say that in this findings, we would say with 95% accuracy that this is a lot of pancreatic necrosis.
Okay, now to the patient.
What?
Now to start the patient.
Yes, we are waiting for general anesthesia. Actually, the intubation is a bit difficult. I am sorry that I put our dear anesthesiologist to this suffering.
Sorry. Put it, please.
Actually, in this case, we perform cystogastrostomy under general anesthesia. It will be more comfortable for everybody. And some endoscopies actually do not do cystogastrostomy without general anesthesia.
It's safer.
It is safer. You see, in some cases the cyst is large, so after you drain it, especially if you put a metallic stent, we are going to do like this, there will be a gush of fluid and the patient would aspirate. Actually, in our unit, we have such aspiration cases. And after that, we always perform under general anesthesia. But if you perform without general anesthesia, then you should be very cautious against aspiration.
I'll
ask a question about the last case, the one with the periapulmonary cancer, because we had a question from the audience. We didn't have time to answer it. They were answering that, or they were asking about the tumor markers in patients with periapulmonary cancer. Will it help or not?
Tumor markers in periapulmonary cancer, actually, if it is elevated, and if it remaining high after biliary drainage, it is valuable. For example, the patient starts with, say, 1,000 CA 99, and then he is jaundiced. You provide biliary drainage, and after 1 week of biliary drainage, it's still 1,000. So it is something. But if the patient presents with a papillary mass with a very high CA 99 after biliary drainage, it returns to normal. So it means that it does not reveal too much thing. So I think if there is no biliary drainage, first of all, one should perform biliary drainage, and after 1 week, if it does not change, it does not drop, it is valuable. I am going to convey one of my very recent experience. A lady presented with jaundice 2 months after cholecystectomy, and actually the son of the patient was a surgeon, and he thought he performed cholestectomy very good, but his mother developed joint receptor tumors. Then I performed EUS and I said this may be papillary carcinoma. And the 99 level is 1550. And I performed biliary drainage with stent. There was no stone, but the findings in papilla was suspicious. And biopsy did not reveal malignancy. But after 2 weeks, the CA99 was still 1,500. And we thought that this is probably a papillary carcinoma. The patient underwent surgery, and in surgery, after pancreatic to duodenoscopy, it was revealed that that was a papillary malignancy. So if it is remaining high after drainage, it is something.
Thank you, that's very useful.
We are very grateful to our anesthesiologist that he managed to...
Thank you.
Very difficult intubation. Now we put the mouth back.
Another item that I referred the patient for surgery, and they reviewed that the general condition of the patient is unfit for surgery. After the PET scan, I consulted the multidisciplinary team. They are not in favor of surgery because all the parameters are with benign cyst, not a malignant cyst, except the PET scan. But in addition to that, the general condition of the patient do not permit major surgery at all. So even any opinion with surgery is cancelled because of the poor condition of the patient. Because the fluid is incisted, hoping that cystogastrostomy with metal stent will solve this problem, inshallah.
We are ready for a metal stent today.
Yes, okay. Yes. It should be metal.
So which one are you going to use?
Lumen opposing, self-expandable metal stent, 4 centimeter.
Okay, that's great.
I think from Hanaro, into care.
Dr. Hussain, will you ask Professor? Will you ask Professor Hakan?
Yes.
Which stent he prefers? Because now we have about 3 companies producing the lumen opposing stents. Which one he prefers?
Which one you have? Yes. Mostly lumen opposing, we try to use lumen opposing stents. These are double picked plastic stents. As to company, there isn't too much difference between Hanaro and Microtech, but Botaxios is more practical, but it is very expensive. So what I am going to say is that Teivun, Hanaro are good lumen opposing stents. Microtech is near to this.
We have a problem with the sound. It goes like. Yes.
Now we are going to start this session. Yeah.
Can we have the EUS picture, please? The EUS beside the industry? Yes.
Now, what we see is gold platter. This is not the cyst.
Now the EUS alone, we need the EUS alone.
Aorta.
Put somebody
go there. Yes. And stabilize the subdural uses, is a bit large. We are examining the pancreatic tail. You see pancreatic tail, left kidney, and spleen are very near to each other. We can now see all together. But up to now, I didn't see any cyst. We are going to examine from duodenum. Could you please hold?
We have the last time he had the examination?
1 month.
Answer it,
so the cyst was in the body?
ممكن تحسين عالي الصوت عند الدكتور هكام؟
Yes, you hear me?
Yes.
Okay.
Now we are examining that of the pancreas, VLP duodenum. You see aorta. If we see abdominal aorta, it means we are in we are improving on in the on the right. You see the pancreatic head. They can pull the head on the left side, Professor Oskar is showing you. Yes, there's a mass here, and we assume that this mass is a necrotic mass. But this is a very complex system, not a very simple one. And it is containing most of these solid parts. So,
what is this mass? Which part of the pancreas?
This is body of the pancreas. It is adjacent to the body of the pancreas.
Still, there is a debate whether these measurements cystic pancreatic neoplasm or.
And you see that here there is a cystic part. Could you please show it? Yes, this is the cystic part, and it is connected to this solid part.
And you are examining from the duodenum?
No, we are examining from the stomach.
From the stomach.
We are
okay.
In the subcardia.
Okay.
And as it was stated in CT examination, it has a very thick wall.
Yes.
Now, our best bet to puncture this is from here. I'm asking for them, because you see that this is a very crucial maneuver. With Professor Okasha, my previous fellow, Ali Trakam, is with me.
Yes.
I am very proud of him.
Okay.
He is doing a very great job. And now he is going to help me.
Very good.
May I have the 19-inch needle, please, now?
Needle Tsapash. We will go to him. So is it safe to puncture a thick wall like this?
There is no problem with the puncture, but you see that the wall is very thick.
Yes.
So in this case, it may be difficult to arrange the cystogastrostomy stem. We are going to cut it to
so the plan
is in all these procedures, you should have a very professional assistant.
Yes.
What I suggest is that while doing these procedures, you should have one to each other. So, for example, if now Halit is performing, I would assist Halit.
Yes.
So you would be one performer, one assistant. So it is not something that always done with junior assistant and senior performer. Sometimes senior performer, senior assistant, but senior junior performer.
So like the stethoscope.
Yes. In any case.
Yes. And now the plan is to put the stent and leave it for a while.
Actually, the plan is that now we are going to see the nature of the cystic fluid. First of all.
Okay.
We should see it like this. Okay. We are checking with no problem, no flow.
دكتور حسين. دكتور حسين.
Yes.
حد يشاور لنا على النيدل والتراك بتاعها. Yes. Good.
Yes. We aspirate the fluid.
Okay. Can you see the fluid?
Okay.
Yeah, very transparent.
كبر الصورة بتاعت الدكتور حكام، كبر الصورة. كبر الصورة لو سمحت.
Yes, that's enough.
It looks like this.
Yes, I will do string sign. ممكن تركز
عليها. Clear,
not so clear. It is slightly turbid, likely infected, but the most important is that it gives positive string sign of mucin or not.
Positive?
No.
Negative
string.
Okay, the guide wire, please.
And the scope, please.
Now go back to the EUS.
Yes.
And the endoscopy. Oh,
that's perfect.
Dr. Asian? Dr. Asian?
It
is better to keep the fluid inside till the insertion of the stent. It may be helpful for insertion or to suck the fluid before.
Could we see the copy picture, please? The copy. Colonoscopy, yes.
Colonoscopy, yes. In the screen.
The tip of the scope, please.
Can you have a screen as well? The X-ray, please.
No, up and this side.
We need the X-ray.
More here. Yeah. More to me. Very, go on.
X-ray, I think, please. شوف الأشعة يا شباب، صورة الأشعة بفضلكم. صورة الأشعة، في حد واقف قدام صورة الأشعة؟ حد طيب خلاص، يدينا اليوس خلاص مش بس، يدينا اليوس خلاص. زوم عليها، زوم.
You see the guide wire is going to the other part of the cyst.
Okay.
Yeah, so it is very good.
Going inside.
Could you please turn it to me? Very good. And make it a bit bigger.
No. Go back.
Cover the US, خلاص مش محتاجين حاجة تاني.
More.
خليك على كده.
Okay, that's okay. Halit, you concentrate here. Now we are withdrawing to push it a little bit. Okay. Wait. Yeah, we are withdrawing. Okay, I am going to arrange. Yes, we are just on the wall. You can. Yes. Good. Go on. Scope, please. CR, press. This is the best position. Yes, now I am going to take the rubber.
Okay, rubber bed.
Oh, very good.
الكاميرا مان ممكن اسالك على حاجه تقول لي منها
دكتور علي شايف ان هنا ما ننساش
الدكتور حسين
دكتور علي
خلي الكاميرا مان يروح ورا الاتش اي اللي هي الناحيه الثانيه
للاشعه دكتور علي مهم ان احنا نحط البلف تاني
طبعا
طيب شايف حاجه
بالبلد
تاني
فوتو؟ ايوه انا معاك، بس انا عايز حاجه بالكاميرا مان.
ايوه
يلف ويجيب صوت الاشعه من ورا الساتر.
هيبقى صعب الدنيا مسلوقه كده.
لا هو يروح الناحيه التانيه بعيد عنكم خالص من ورا الساتر، يروح على الجهاز نفسه يجيب الصوره مع الجهاز نفسه. معايا حسين؟
تقدر تبص على
تاني ورا الدكتور خالد؟ لا مش ورا الدكتور خالد.
من ورا الساتر.
من ورا الساتر. من ورا من ورا خالص.
هتلاقي الصورة دي موجودة عندك ورا هنا.
Yes, this
is better. Six is working.
Yes. Aspiration is not working.
Yes,
ورينا بقى صوت الأشعة لو وصلت لنا. أيوه ركز على الصورة بتاعت الأشعة.
Yes, keep it in this position. Okay. Victor, support please, radiologist.
Yes.
Sequin, yeah.
Yes, okay.
Could you please decrease light a bit?
Lights. Just one.
Decrease the lights, please. More. Yes, that's good. But I cannot see. Could you please? Yes.
More. But it is a good thing, so I cannot understand why.
What you said is very crazy. Yes. Thank you.
Yeah, but I cannot see the people who have 6 grams as well.
صورة الـ EUS يا في كنترول
فيترو تلفو فيترو مور فيترو استاذ بوشو فيترو مور يس فيترو اسحب
There is a problem with this photon. Is there another photon?
You are paying attention?
Different.
This is the infrared?
No, this is
the infrared. You see, I cannot see the cisco. It is not going out. That's the problem. I think it is a bit old. Yes. Because this is an old one.
Yes.
Really? Don't we have any other six Francis button? No. Set way. No, it is best guy. Maybe throw the guy.
No.
The guide is out because there is something wrong with this one. Anyway, we are going to, you see, if the accessories are not proper, this is always a problem because you see, push the needle, push the guide wire, please. Yes.
The EUS again? EUS,
please.
They are experiencing some problems with accessories. 19 gauge again, please. This guideline is very
stiff. This is a side. This is a
side. Okay.
So, Alex.
You see, we should find the best position. Otherwise, the problem. Yes, we are going to get it. Yes, you ask for it, please. The aspiration.
Hey, this is
Senegal. So we check some saline.
Yes.
I think this is organized fluid. But anyway, it would be better to put the step there. Because if you put the other side, the brain is going to be surprised. Yeah, thank you, sir. You see, this is a complicated set, so we should get the best decision to get the best result. No rush. Say that. And we see some coagulant coming out of the cavity, so this is probably bleeding into the cavity, and because of this, it is like this. So now we should decide whether we are going to drain it or not, but you see this is not a very good place to drain, so we are going to change the place. That is not the place we actually want to perform the procedure, because we are not sure what is happening there, and if we perform this in a solid mess, it would result with free perforation. It would be a problem. That is something to be avoided. From this appearance, we should at least have some necrotic fluid coming out of it. If it is not coming, we cannot make sure that this is. This side is better, I think. Yes, any question?
Yes. Now the audience here are commenting on the white echoes inside the cavity. Some persons here are suggesting that it's gas inside the cavities, and this is gas forming the organism. What do you think?
If it is infected necrosis, surely there may be a carcinoid, but it seems that this is rather solid material. You see, very, very large solid material. Actually, before we make sure that we are in the right place, we cannot go around. Sorry? Yeah, yeah, before the first place. In any way, what we see is that the space between the cystic cavity and the gastric wall is too long. You see, this is the cavity and this is the stomach wall. So the space is more than yes, 1 centimeter, and furthermore, in this cystic cavity, I cannot define a stable capsule. That is a problem. In these cases, we should be very cautious, because you see that if you try to drain cyst without a verified capsule like pseudocyst, then it will result with pre-perforation. So we do not want to call the surgeon in time. Yeah, yes. And now you see that the space between the stomach wall and the cavity is like 6 millimeters, not too long, but problematic. So this is not something we could happily drain. And you see the fluid part is very, very small, yeah. You keep the position.
But you think about the indication.
Okay, okay, okay. Good. Wait. Yes, now we must see.
Who?
Yes. Oh. And aspirin.
That is ring a rush.
Aspirin. Also. Right here.
Yes.
It looks like right. Not stiff part. Yes, anyway, we are in the yes, we are inside.
You have some saline?
Yes. Yes, 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 that's okay.
Why? Aspirate again? Okay, no need to aspiration.
Yes, blood and necrotic fluid.
So it seems to be like a necrotic area at the moment. It's not feasible for the gastric. So it would be complicated.
deep perforation.
No localized.
Yes. Actually, my decision is that this is a necrotic area around the pancreas, but it is not very well localized. And the fluid coming is a blood stained fluid, and there is no certain wall. So this is still a necrotic area in evolution. And it is not suitable for cystogastrostomy at the moment. Maybe we should wait for some time. Other, if the patient is really symptomatic, then we would put some percutaneous approach. Actually, we can do cystogastrostomy here. But the problem is that even if it is not a very high probability, it would result with pre-perforation. So the patient would need surgery, because you see that it is a large area. And we do not have any defined border. So we are going to put stent, but I think we are not going to drain too much fluid. And the patient may need a surgery. What do you think?
Yes, yes. I think there is no local here. It must be irregular, no localized space, no confined space. So I think it will invite infection, just invite infection with no...
With no benefits. Not only infection, but it would result with free air in all of the abdomen. So...
Mr. Kasir?
Yes?
I think we all agree with you. There is no confined wall to do
yes.
At the present time.
Yes, then we all agree that it is not a suitable case for cystogastrostomy.
Yes,
for
we agree with you.
In this case, we should wait for some time that it would transform into a wall of necrosis, because if we perform it now, as Professor Okasha said, we would invite a serious infection. Yes. Furthermore, we would result with free perforation. So, for the benefit of the patient, what I suggest is that to have another CT examination, and the patient is symptomatic state, to put a percutaneous drain. If you compare it to the previous case, in the previous case, you have observed a very well defined 100% system. But for this one, you see it is very complicated, no defined border, away from stomach wall. I think we should not do it. Otherwise, people do not have it. So our diagnosis is peripancreatic necrotizing pancreatitis, still in evolution.
Yes. Okay.
Thank you. Now if we are ready with the next room.
Yes.
We will just be happy to have the his presentation.
Thank you.